हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम अनुजा श्रीवास्तव एंड टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द नेक्स्ट चैप्टर इन द क्लास 7 बायोलॉजी एंड द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज ह्यूमन बॉडी इन विच आई एम गोइंग टू टेल यू अबाउट द एक्सक्रीटरी सिस्टम। सो एक्सक्रीटरी सिस्टम, इट इज रिलेटेड विद द एक्सक्रीशन। दैट मीन्स यू मस्ट नो अबाउट द एक्सक्रीशन। So excretion is the process by which metabolic waste are removed from our body. It is a process by which metabolic waste remove from our body. Now question arises, what is the need to remove these waste from our body? It is very necessary because when these metabolic waste are accumulate in our body, that means when they are going to increase in our body, it is very harmful for our body and it starts killing the cells in our body. That's why it is very necessary to remove these waste from our body. Now there are one complete system is given in our body for the excretion. That means it is very important topic. But before starting that complete excretion system, let us know about some excretory organ. Some excretory organ other than kidney, so that you must know about these things. So first organ that you must know, that is the lungs. Now why lungs is the part of excretory system? Yes, it is a part of excretory system because during the respiration, when the respiration takes place, it breaks down the glucose in the presence of oxygen and remove what they are going to remove. That means after the process of respiration, CO2 is released. And this CO2 is going to exhale from our body. That's why CO2 is an excretory product and lungs is an excretory organ. Second one is the skin. Now, skin, as you all know, the skin is going to release the sweat. That means skin having number of sweat gland and oil glands. And these both glands are going to release the waste. Sweat glands, as you know, it is going to release the sweat. And what is sweat? Sweat is water. That means sweat is combination of water, salt and urea. So this is removed from the sweat gland. And oil gland, as you all know, you are just saying my skin is oily, my skin is normal, my skin is dry. That is also related with these oil gland, because oil gland, it is released the sebum. And sebum is a fatty substance. It is a fatty substance just like a oil which is released from the skin. Now the third one is the kidney. And about kidney, you will also study in complete excretory system. So kidney, it is going to release nitrogenous waste. It is going to release nitrogenous waste from the body. And one more function it is performed, that is it is performed osmoregulation. And what is osmoregulation? It is a balance of water and salt content in the body. It is balance between water and salt content in the body. Okay. So the next excretory organ, which is also very important, that is the liver. So the next one is the liver. Now you were already studied about liver related to the when you are going to study about the digestive system, but now the liver is the excretory organ, but you come to know how liver is the excretory organ. So liver, it forms urea. It forms urea. How it forms urea? With the excess of amino acid. Okay, and as you know, urea is a nitrogenous waste, so it is very, very necessary to remove it from our body. So this urea, this passes to the kidney, and from the kidney it is going to release from our body. Now one more function is performed by the liver, that is the bile pigment. That is, other than urea, bile pigment is also forms inside the liver. And how this bile pigment form? It is formed by the breakdown of hemoglobins, red blood, old and worn out cells. That means jo red blood cells purani ho jati hain, old ho jati hain, rupture ho jati hain, unka breakdown kiya jata hai, unse bile pigment banaya jata hai. And that bile pigment, it is passes to the duodenum, which is a part of large intestine, and it is releases with the it is released from the large intestine along with the feces. That means how bile pigment is formed? It is formed by the breakdown of hemoglobin old and worn out RBC. And this bile pigment, it passes to duodenum, and from where it releases with along with the feces. Now let's start the important topic of this chapter, on which the name of this chapter is there, that is the human excretory system. So human excretory system, it consists of a pair of kidney a tube like structure which is known as the ureter, then urinary bladder, and urethra. These four are going to form the human excretory system. So today I am only going to tell you about the structure of human kidney. So let's see the structure of kidney. Now human kidney, it is a bean shaped structure which is reddish brown in color, and it is located just above the waist. So let's see, bean shaped, reddish brown in color, and also I told you in pair, found in pair. And one more important thing, where it is located? Located just above the waist. Okay, now I already drawn the diagram of kidney over here, but before going toward that, one more thing I want to tell you. The right kidney positioned slightly lower, that is right kidney is lower than that of the left. Now look at this diagram here. it is the internally the kidney is divided into two part. First is the outer dark part, which is known as the renal cortex, and inner light part, which is known as the renal medulla. That means kidney is divided into two part, renal cortex and renal medulla. Now internally it is having funnel shaped wide structure, which is known as the renal pelvis. Okay, now this renal pelvis is going to open into the ureter, through which the urine is released from kidney to the other part of the excretory system. And the function of kidney, if I am going to tell you about the function of kidney, so the function of kidney is filter the blood to remove urea. That means kidney is going to filter the blood, and the blood will be now urea free, and the excess water, urea and some salts are released in the form of urine, which is a straw colored liquid. So this is all about the today's topic. I hope you all are understand the things which I had explained to you. Now watch the video. Till then, bye bye and thank you.